Sailing in Greenlandic waters is, when even possible, done under circumstances that differs from the rest of the world. The main factor is the sea ice off the coast of the huge island that is very different from east coast to west coast. The East Greenlandic current, coming from the Arctic Sea, runs between Svalbard and Greenland and continues south through the Denmark Strait between Greenland and Iceland. The icing current brings a flow of polar ice with it in a belt several hundred kilometers wide. In the cold months, this flow reaches not just Cape Farewell at the southern tip of Greenland, but reaches up the southern west coast too. This makes the entire east coast inaccessible by ship during winter, while during the late summer it only reaches Scoresby Sund, leaving the east coast accessible a few months of the year. The ice at the east coast thus consists of both locally formed ice and many years old ice from the polar region. The ice on the west coast is only formed locally, and this area is thus much more accessible. The east coast is mostly inaccessible by ship due to the ice, save for the few months in late summer when it is possible to reach the two settlements at Anmarsalik and Scoresby Sund. The west coast is closed part of the year from Thule down to Sisimiut, but from here down to the eastern ice in the south, it is mostly ice-free all year. This is due to a warm current from the south, leaving this part of the coast mostly accessible year-round. Mostly accessible is the important note here. All around the coast of Greenland you can meet icebergs. Most and largest of these are found along the west coast, and some of these are caught in the Labrador Current being brought down into the North Atlantic sailing routes. This is what happened to the Titanic in 1912. Aside from the dangers posed by the ice, there are violent storms that suddenly kick in, and when the temperature is below freezing, the ship risks being iced over. Many tons of ice can quickly settle on a ship, which not only weighs the ship down, but also causes instability. Add to this that the immense coast is sparsely populated and badly marked with lighthouses. If something goes wrong, help is far away, if at all available. This all makes it clear that sailing in Greenlandic waters has historically and even today required special ships and rugged sailors to connect the disparate communities. Thus, nimble ships that were highly maneuverable and enforced against the ice were commonly used. Among these, the schooner that was very much used in these waters. The sailing ships also lasted long in Greenland because it was less prone to damage from the ice, which could smash the propeller of a steamship or motor ship. Generally, sail ships were also easier to repair with the available tools in the isolated communities. This meant that it was not until recently that enforced motor ships could be brought into service in Greenland. And even then, it was mostly to the larger harbors with local traffic still using sail schooners. And of course, even today, With enforced motor ships having taken over, the coast is still only accessible when the ice allows it.